Thank you for the introduction, Giovanni. So today I will tell you about our recent work with our collaborators from New York University and NIST in Washington on easy plane spin hole nano oscillators for neuromorphic computing. So over the past few years, it has been shown that spintronic nano oscillators can emulate neurons at nanoscale. And a few different experimental realizations of small neural networks have been done, successfully demonstrating different learning tasks. For example, reservoir computing with a single nano oscillator to recognize spoken digits, or spoken vowel classification using a small neural network of four spin torque oscillators. But it has not yet been demonstrated in spintronics the spiking behavior that is found in biological neurons. Indeed, biological neurons have this very efficient way to encode information, which is in the rate of the voltage spikes that they emit. And this type of information encoding is actually very interesting for neuromorphic computing because it could allow the implementation of a learning rule that is called the spike timing dependent plasticity, and which is actually completely local, which means that it only requires locally available information to calculate the weight updates in a neural network. And there is another system in mesoscopic physics that actually naturally produces this spiking behavior, and those are Josephson junctions. Indeed, in Josephson junctions, the superconducting phase difference that is noted delta here is described by this differential equation here, which is governed by their resistance, capacitance, and critical current. And they can actually emit voltage spikes that are only equal to multiples of the single flux quantum. So recently, it has been shown in this beautiful work that easy plane antiferromagnetic spin hole nano oscillators, at least in theory, could reproduce this same dynamics, where here you see that the precession phase phi is described by the same differential equation, where this exchange coupling plays the role of the capacitance, the damping plays the role of the resistance, and easy axis anisotropy plays the role of the critical current. But the problem is that today it is still quite challenging to realize antiferromagnetic devices, because in particular it is quite hard to grow antiferromagnets with sufficiently large domains to realize oscillators. And this has motivated us to show that similar dynamics can be obtained with easy plane ferromagnetic spin hole nano oscillators, which are much more easy to fabricate experimentally. However, they have a quite different geometry from the usual spintronic oscillators, in the sense that they have this easy plane that has to be perpendicular to the polarization of the spin current, which if we're using spin hole effect to polarize current, means that it needs to be perpendicular to the film stack. And also, this gives a hard axis to this material, which plays the role of the exchange coupling. And also we need an easy axis that is here given by this long shape anisotropy, which makes it possible for the magnetization to make just a single turn in this easy plane and then quickly relax towards this initial position along the easy axis. So we have performed micromagnetic simulations in MuMax to show that we can indeed obtain such perpendicular easy plane materials. And the approach we use is to take a perpendicular magnetic anisotropy material, such as cobalt, iron, boron, deposited on platinum. And then we adjust its thickness in a way to compensate this perpendicular magnetic anisotropy by the demagnetizing field. So this is what you see here. The transition happens when the magnetization switches from the X orientation along the EZ axis in blue to the perpendicular axis in red. Then in a second time, we show that this anisotropy properties can be conserved in the nanoconstriction architecture, and we choose geometry parameters that can be realized with e-beam lithography, so 60 nanometer width and 300 nanometer length. And then we see that for critical currents of about 1.5 10 to the power of 10 ampere per square meter, which is comparable to current densities that are used in spin torque nano oscillators, we obtain these nice big circular oscillations in the EZ plane. So now we want to propose two ways to use these spin hole oscillators for neuromorphic computing. We want to realize them in chains of nanoconstrictions. And then we can either use spike propagation in these chains, so similarly to what biological neurons do, or alternatively, we could use them in the regime of continuous oscillations and tune the coupling between the oscillators. So we begin by simulating a single nanoconstriction, and we can detect its magnetization dynamics either through the anisotropic magnetoresistance effect, or if we want to increase the signal, we can add a magnetic tunnel junction stack on top of this device and detect it through tunneling magnetoresistance. And this is what I'm plotting here. So now we want to inject the current pulse only for the duration that corresponds to a single oscillation period in this EZ plane. And then what happens is that magnetization makes a single turn and then it relaxes towards this initial position. And this corresponds to a single spike in the TMR. And then it takes about 50 nanoseconds for these little oscillations to relax completely. And after these 50 nanoseconds, which we can inject a second pulse and obtain a second spike and so along. Now, if we realize a chain of such nanoconstrictions, for example, here there are three neurons that are connected through these two islands, we can inject a constant current bias in the whole chain. And then this bias is lower than the critical current threshold that would be needed for the oscillations. And we only add a current pulse into the first neuron. And then thanks to the spin wave propagation in these islands, we can propagate these spikes down the constriction. So here you see in the TMR, we have the first neuron that spikes in blue, and then a few nanoseconds later, the second neuron spikes in red. And then a bit later, the third neuron spikes in green. Now we can also demonstrate the synaptic functionality where we locally modify the anisotropy in this island by, for example, applying a DC voltage just there. And then what happens is that we break the magnetization dynamics in this island such that only the first neuron keeps spiking and the spikes do not propagate down the chain. Or alternatively, we can also modify the weight in the synapse between the second and third neuron, and then only the first two neuron spikes and the third one doesn't. Another approach is to continuously drive these oscillator neurons and to tune the coupling between them by modifying the weight of the synapse that it is implemented by this island. So here you see that the oscillators, oscillating phase, so the red one and the blue one, for about 22 nanoseconds, and then they start dephasing. And if we modify the anisotropy in this island, then they dephase much faster after only about 10 nanoseconds. So we could try to quantify this coupling as a function of anisotropy by plotting the standard deviation of the phase difference between the two neurons. And we see that it breaks, the coupling breaks, when we change the anisotropy by about 10%. And alternatively, we could look into the correlation coefficient between the TMRs of the two neurons, and we obtain the same result. We see that the coupling breaks at about 10% change in the anisotropy. So yes, we have shown that in principle we could obtain spiking neurons using these easy plane spin hole nano oscillators, and we have started fabricating the samples. So I hope we'll have some experimental results soon. Thank you.